Use cases for serverless. In this video, we're going to talk about when it's a good idea to use serverless and when it's not such a good idea. Serverless is not always the right technology. Here are some general rules of thumb that you can apply to any operation to see if serverless would be a good fit. Serverless is good for any operation that experiences low or burstable traffic. What I mean by burstable is that the operation may be rarely called or it may be called a whole lot, but we don't know. So it's not called at all, and then it's called thousands of times within a few seconds, then it goes back to being not called at all a few seconds later and stays that way for a long time. This is erratic and burstable traffic. The reason for this is cost. You only want to pay when your function is running, and if you are building a system with a lot of high traffic and a lot of load or predictable demand, serverless might not be the best option for you because you might actually end up paying more. In that case, you might want to look at traditional hosting systems like a virtual machine and or an actual platform as a service like Azure's application service, where you can prepay for a certain amount of compute. Serverless is a great option, though, for operations and processes that need to be triggered by other events somewhere else in your system. This is because with serverless, you are event-driven, and so you don't have to wire up all of these events that you need to listen to yourself. You just tell the function to fire whenever the event happens, and it sort of just works. Let's look at some concrete use cases or examples of where serverless really shines. Traditional APIs are a great option for serverless. These are endpoints that you create where a server acts as the API for your application. Often, the server is just talking to a database and either retrieving data or making updates on behalf of the application. This is a particularly great option for single-page applications. These are applications that are built with front-end JavaScript frameworks like Angular, Vue, or React. And in fact, it's such a great option that Azure Functions is built into the new Azure Static Web Apps offering because it's just the easiest way to stand up an API for your single page application. Image processing is another good one. You may have an application that allows the user to upload a photo. You then need to resize that photo to make a thumbnail out of it. Instead of building all that into your application, what you do is write a serverless function that watches for that file to be uploaded and then takes it and transforms it into the scaled down thumbnail image. This is especially useful if you've already written the application that uploads the photo and you don't want to have to crack that code open and make a bunch of changes and then redeploy that application code. You could just write a serverless function that does all that for you without modifying the application whatsoever. Bots are also a particularly good use case for serverless because bots respond to human behavior, and human behavior is unpredictable. This can be bots like chatbots, bots with auto reply with a message like updating a customer on the status of an order via a text or a chat message, or service bots, bots that do things like pull in data or more information when you paste a link into Slack or Microsoft Teams. Human behavior is by definition unpredictable and erratic. You don't know for certain how many people are going to sign up to receive those order updates. You don't know how many are going to try to talk to your bot to get the FAQs answered. You don't know whether a customer will opt out of updates. Serverless is great for these scenarios because you don't know how much of these things will be used, and you don't want to be charged when they're not being used. In summary, you should use serverless when you have low or burstable traffic. You should also use serverless when you need to respond to events that are happening somewhere else in your system and you don't want to have to wire that stuff up yourself. Do not use serverless if you have a high amount of traffic and it's predictable. You can predict the traffic. In that case, look to traditional hosting solutions, which might actually give you more bang for your buck.